I am so excited about Bleach Rebirth of Souls, a console game that we've been waiting for a really, really, really long time. And we finally have it. We finally have the gameplay. It's took me a while to make this video because I kind of wanted to understand the mechanics and see what exactly I was looking at here. Because before I even show you the trailer and give you my breakdown and thoughts on it, there was a lot going on. It is different from what we expect from arena fighters. Obviously, Budokai Tenkaichi 4 or Sparking Meteor with Dragon Ball coming out. And of course, we have the Storm series, which is the most famous in terms of like the arena fighter genre. So, to see Bleach in this way and its HUD in a different light, trying to kind of figure out everything that's going on, the mechanics, has been very interesting nonetheless. And we're going to talk about that. But first, I want to just show the trailer, give my thoughts as I'm watching it. And yeah, let's just jump into it. But before we get into that, hit that like, that subscribe if you want to see more Bleach Rebirth of Souls videos, because you are going to regardless. I'm going to be doing so many videos talking about the roster, talking about just everything in terms of what the directors are saying, because I am all in on this game and I hope it does well, because this trailer so far looking pretty good. So hit that like, that subscribe, hit the subscription and hit the bell notification as well, just in case. And with that being said, let's get into the video, shall we? The editing's a bit crazy, so I kind of want to see the game without all the editing. But the story mode looks crazy. As I said, and I had to pause it, but as I said when we first saw this game that I thought it was going to be like Kakarot. And the thing is, Kakarot can still have, like, the gameplay can still be like Kakarot, of course. Like, Kakarot in and of itself, even though it's open world, is an arena fighter in and of itself when it comes to the fight scenes. The only problem with Kakarot is that it's very, very, very story driven and doesn't have an online aspect, right? But Bleach can have both. It can have a really strong Kakarot-style story mode. And it's still possible, like walking around and doing side quests, blah, blah, blah. It still can have that. But the main thing is arena fire. Obviously, I think I'm asking too much. But still, the story could be solid. And I have to say, I was wrong. Of course, it's an arena fighter and not an RPG like Kakarot. But regardless of what, as long as the story is good, which it looks to be, the Ichigo in a road, they fought in an alleyway. But I mean, hey, look, I'm not going to be super specific. It's a game. You know, it is what it is. But of course, we're getting a little bit of the story here, of course, with Byakuya versus Ichigo. And I think that's the main point of this trailer, is showcasing Ichigo and Byakuya. Again, very beautiful. The visuals, the models, beautiful. And this is just gorgeous.
I want to win.
Wielding swords that personify so soul. Yeah, to kind of figure out what I guess there's like the intros to like how the game starts when like you pick your characters, they all do their like little intros. Not to anyone. Your powers fall far short of mine. Unless it's a story mode, which is quite possible too. So we start off with this. This is the camera angle we got. Very good. It's better than seeing like Naruto Storm where it's kind of like a back shot. Ha. So getting a side profile is quite different and better, because this is how I envision the Bleach game. Now, first off the bat, you're going to see some flash steps with Ichigo and, of course, Byakuya evading with his own flash steps, which is really cool. I'm sorry, I'm going to play the trailer and not do the breakdown. But it looks beautiful. The HDUI is not... Look, it's very flashy, but it's not over the top where it's, like, overbearing the screen. Now, is that... an effect of the video, or is that going to be in the game itself? I assume it's just going to not be in the game, obviously. I think there's a lot of effects here that are very misleading. But it's I want to see what it's like as a normal fighting experience rather than the story mode, because I feel like a lot of the story mode is adding a lot of cutscenes. So we're not getting like a full idea of what it's going to look like. But there's some things on here that have caught my eye already. And of course, Byakuya Senpai Daikaku absolutely looks beautiful. Everything is looking... Look, when they said that they were really focused on the visuals for this game, I was a little bit worried that's all they focused on, but the gameplay looks great too. And there is actually blood. When you go frame by frame, even though it doesn't, blood doesn't show on the character models, you can see in slashes that there is bits of blood. And the reason why I think there's no blood within this game is because at the end of the day, or to not make it obvious, they want this to appeal to a certain audience, a certain demographic, to get kids, teenagers, and adults to enjoy this. If it was too bloody and gory, maybe certain kids wouldn't be able to play because their parents are strict, or like some stores wouldn't allow it. I don't know. Maybe it's to do with the gaming rating, age rating. So I'm not too annoyed at that, to be honest with you. Ichigo Kurosaki. And this is to show the awakening. Going Bankai. And then, again, going into this. I wonder if it's going to have any actual buffs. The music's sick too. But I wonder if it's going to have any buffs. Like, is damage going to be increased? How much buy? Because there's a lot of games like Dragon Ball where you can just go Super Saiyan and it doesn't really increase anything. It just is the same, just with maybe a different moveset. But again, beautiful, absolutely gorgeous. Let the next clash decide this battle. And the backgrounds and the layout's great too. So there you go, there's our trailer. So there's things I want to talk about, giving yourself a little breakdown. Also, the mask is very pog. As you guys know, that this is going to the Rankai arc, so all the way up to Aizu versus Ichigo and Mugetsu. There's things that I wanted to bring up in this, and that's the HUD. Just to give a breakdown in simple terms, because I've seen a few YouTubers talk about this, and I've also seen a few Twitter posts, and have not really elaborated very clearly. In a sense, you have 9 health bars. 9 health bars. That's essentially what this is. The 9 that you see up there is 9 health bars, right? The bar underneath, when you get that down to 0, that's when the health bars deplete. Of course, you can start off, depending on the move that you do, can get rid of more health bars than another move, right? Simple as put. At the bottom where you see reverse, obviously Ichigo in this moment has hit 7 times, and obviously as he hits more, that goes up higher. If I can probably try and skip, there you go, it goes higher, and when that yellow bar is full, you can do certain abilities. What I mean by this is, for example, when Ichigo goes Bankai here, there is a certain proc where it says, there you go, can you keep up? So obviously with this, like there might be some moves where it might take 2 or 3 bars. So obviously a 3 bar attack is going to be more stronger than a 1 bar attack. The can you keep up, obviously everybody knows this, as he comes up behind Byakuya and obviously like stabs him from behind. And also rapid slash, which is obviously where Ichigo does like the rapid attacks with Byakuya's petals all coming. So there you go. You can't really choose rapid slash, so I assume that that's a 2 bar move. Then you have the reversals too, which I imagine are like shadow clones in or substitution jutsus, much like in Storm, where obviously you can just like get out of a situation and do a reverse, and or even just flash step out of a way. But it seems like there's only 2 in this instance, or maybe the bar is like if you use a flash step, it only takes a little bit. But either way, this is your reversal. Don't know what the reverse thing is when it's actually proc'd, and like when it's big, like there was another proc there too, an all-out slash and wielding. I don't really know what that one is. Yeah, so depending on the strength of the attack, obviously the more that your bar is gonna go down. It's a very simple mechanic, kind of dressed up a bit differently, but at the end of the day, I like the concept, because they've gone for a system that is based off lore, using certain attacks that get rid of certain health bars, the build-up, the reversal. I think it gives a great opportunity. Even though it is its own mechanic in and of its own, I'm just using examples from Dragon Ball and Storm just to equate a certain familiarity. But it is its own kind of aspect, and I love it. I think it's great. I wonder if, obviously, because there's only 2 moves, I wonder if people are going to get bored of these type of movesets. Though at the same time, I guess if you have a Bankai 2, you're going to have four movesets and a different fighting style. But I think through watching this trailer that you are going to have a very versatile fighting style even without using special moves. And special moves seem to be something like, I mean, if you're going to play Dragon Ball, you know, you can like charge up and then just like usually you can choose from like triangle, circle, X or square different attacks like Destructo Disc or Ki Blast or Meteor Smash or X, Y and Z, right? With that, you know, you can just keep spamming abilities, and it's kind of the same with Naruto. But for this, it seems like you aren't so much relying on purely these special attacks, but more so they are a means to an end to get a significant amount of damage on your opponent, and then you have to kind of build it up again for you to use that attack, which is very, I think, good if that is the case. I think there's a lot as well for me to learn about this mechanic, and I'm very interested. Here you go. Here's a perfect screenshot. So you can do a reverse action or a flash step. So that's what it means by reverse. Now, of course, Byakuya's is more blocky than Ichigo's. So I wonder what the difference is there. But as you can see that these two have different mechanics built into them that can change the game. Like you can reverse to a counter or you can get the fuck out of the way. And I think that that's a really good mechanic to have in and of itself. So I think it's very fairly simple. I'm very, very excited about this game. It looks absolutely beautiful. Ichigo's Bankai looks so cool too. And it's all about just the little things now, like what do you do after the story? What kind of bonuses is there? What kind of content are we adding? What's the online going to be like? What's the roster going to be like? Everyone's going to have different playstyles, like Uryu with range, Ichigo with close combat. I'm pretty sure Byakuya is probably like mid combat. So like there's going to be different playstyles, you know, which is going to be probably hand to hand. So all these different styles are going to be so fun to dabble into. As far as we know, you know, like Yoruichi is confirmed. Aizen's definitely going to be confirmed. The main four, Orihime, Chad, Ichigo, hopefully White. White's going to be thrown into there. The Vizards, all the captains, all the Espada, and then the little random people sprinkled in between is going to be nice. Don Kanoji, no, I'm joking, but still, I'm very excited for this game, and hopefully it's going to be a big roster. Bleach is known for its big roster, and as far as the gameplay goes, the music, I don't think Bleach has ever, and I mean ever, failed with music. So, yeah, it looks like a beautiful game, and I cannot wait to get my grubby little hands on it. And I'll just say this now. You know, if you are going to pick up this game, which I do recommend, go support Bleach. But I will say the unfortunate thing is for everybody, and this is for those that watch until the end of this video, to comment in the comment section down below so I know that you're a real one. I will say get the game by all means, but you're only going to have 50% of the fun. And the reason why I say that is because you're only going to be playing story. Because if you jump online, then chances are you are going to match with me and I'm absolutely going to bully the fuck out of all of you. So it is what it is. I wouldn't even attempt going online because it'd just be embarrassing for you. So, I mean, just stick to story, enjoy the story, enjoy the extra content, but don't even bother. Don't even bother online. Like, just, it's not worth it. It's not worth it. But with that being said, I'm going to catch my focus that you guys, of course, have this fine David Hansen. And as always, people, have an awesome fucking day. And peace out.